Step two of creating a dichotomous key is actually creating the key, mapping it out. So previously we looked at our data and figured out how we can actually differentiate, and now we're going to start putting this all together. So we had 4 gram-negative cocci. So to actually start drawing it out in our flowchart, we want to write out our 4 organisms, write the first test. So the first differentiating test was our glucose fermentation test. We knew that 2 were positive and 2 were negative. So we write the test here in the middle of the flowchart. We know that 2 were positive for acid, and the proper nomenclature for that, for our glucose fermentation test or phenol fermentation test, is A if they produce acid. So then we list the 2 organisms below. If something is a negative fermentation test, or in that general negative for a test, we would write minus, and then the 2 organisms that were negative for that test below. And in this case, we only had 2 groups, only had 2 options, and so we'll only divide in 2. The next step is to divide those groups or those 2 species into 2 again. So let's start over here with the positive for glucose fermentation. We had decided that the way to differentiate those 2 organisms was with a nitrate reduction test, because this organism was positive for nitrate. So you can see how we put a plus, and this one was negative for nitrate. And so now from our flowchart, we can see if an organism that we had started with from those 4 had a glucose positive reaction and positive for nitrate, we know that it is this species. If we come over here to this side of the flowchart, we decided the methyl red test was the way to differentiate these 2. 1 was positive, 1 was negative. So that same logic applies here. If we had performed a glucose test, it was negative, and then negative for methyl red, we know it was MBOVIS. So drawing out the key is really, we just want to continue to subdivide all of our groups until we've actually narrowed it down so that there's only 1 organism in each group. And if we go back a slide, we can see we've been successful with this key, and that from our first set of 4 organisms, we now have 1 organism at the end of each one of our branches or at the end of our flowchart. We can identify each one by their set of characteristics. This is the end of video 2. We'll look at step 3 in the next video.